Hey, God bless you, church family. God is good on this Saturday, August 14th. Almost half the month is gone. Man, it was hot the last 2 days. Anyway, so today we're on the 11th chapter of 1 Corinthians. And again, the Lord's Supper is in there, which is so powerful. But I like verse 1. Imitate me, just as I also imitate Christ. To live a life that you could tell people to go ahead and imitate you, to look at you, that they'll see Jesus in you. Amen? All right, we're done with the continent of Africa. Now we're going to be doing the Americas. And what it says here is the Americas include two continents, 58 countries and territories. The main languages are English, Spanish, Portuguese, and French. Population about 940 million. Christian, 809 million. Evangelical Christian, 192 million. All right, so we're going to start praying for the Americas. We'll start tomorrow with Argentina. We'll go ahead and lift up the entire continent right now. So let's go ahead and pray. Father, we thank you for this Saturday, Lord. It's like these weeks are just blowing by, but all that's going on in our world, Lord, we see what's going on in Afghanistan. Poor leadership is causing just destruction around the world. When we're calling for peace and safety just last year, now we're seeing trouble everywhere, Lord. We pray that the Americans can get out of our Afghanistan. But we also pray for the people in this area as we see the Taliban, ISIS, and other terrorist groups taking over one city, one area after another. We pray over this in Jesus' name. We pray for Italy and this other area that's just having major fires, Lord. Some of the hottest temperatures ever recorded in their areas. We pray over this situation, Lord. We know these things are going to happen. That's why we are looking up, Lord. But we also care about the people, Lord. Watching that one farmer trying to get his cattle out of that field with all the fires going on, Lord. We pray over this situation. Lord, as we see more sin progressing in our world, and as we see leaders broadcasting sin, allowing sin, encouraging sin, we know we're going to see more devastating things on this earth. But we are looking up because we are at warp speed, because scripture must be fulfilled. People say, I pray different now for the leaders than I used to. I sure do, Lord. I pray for their souls, Lord. Eternity is a long time to be wrong. We pray for the United States government, from the executive legislation and judicial to governors, mayors, Lord. On and on, we pray for these leaders in our country, Lord. We pray, Father, that you would touch their hearts, Lord. Touch their hearts in a big way, Lord. To turn things around for the good of the people, Lord. That people can see Jesus Christ. We are a Judeo-Christian nation, Lord. And I pray till the time we go up that we will continue to be. So we as watchmen who are on the walls praying and watching, knowing the return of the Lord is so soon, and we care for humanity. Oh, Lord, we don't want to see people go through the tribulation and on throughout eternity. We pray for this United States, but we also pray for the world. We pray, Father, for Israel. We pray, Father, for the peace of Jerusalem. We pray for the nations. We lift up the Americas, Canada, the United States, Mexico, and South America, Father. So many people are Christians and so many aren't, Lord. We pray, Almighty God, for a touch in this area. Father, I don't know if we're going to have a revival before that trumpet sounds, an awakening, Lord. Whatever, we're praying. We hold back darkness. We make the waters dirty and muddy for these evil people that they can't move their evil agendas through, Lord. We slow them down in Jesus' name. And we pray for their salvation, Father. We pray for our president, our vice president, all those that are in the executive branch. We pray for our congressmen, our senators, our House of Representatives, all those that are in that branch, Lord. We pray for governors, judges, Lord, that are making decisions, Lord. We pray that they would make godly decisions, Lord, godly decisions. We pray over the violence in our cities, Lord. People being killed, a father killing two children, people being mugged on street or in broad daylight, Lord. We pray for our country. We're going down a slippery slope, Lord, and we know it's all aiming towards that great reset, the one world government and all. But till then, we're still here, and we're the salt of the earth. We're the light of this world. So we pray. We pray for our church service on Sunday and every church service. We want to get this thing done, Lord. So we pray, Father. We pray over our nation and our world. Now we pray for one another, Lord. We're encouraged in you, Lord, as we see these devastating floods in Turkey, Lord, and other lands, and the ones we saw a couple weeks ago, and this tropical storm moving up through, possibly through Florida. We pray, Father, for people, Lord, for people. And I thank you for my brothers and sisters today. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your love. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You know, with all the bad news that's out there, I put on Facebook yesterday a one-hour video from Olive Tree Ministries, and it's about the rapture. It's about the judgment seat of Christ, the Bema seat. It's about the millennial reign of Christ. It's about the new heaven and the new earth. So if you need some encouragement with all that's going on, go ahead and watch that. You'll enjoy it. It's in my, on my personal one, not the church one. Amen. Tom and Diane, Pastor Tom and Diane Fiola. Amen. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Have an awesome day.